Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough! Still the same day! Yeah, I know I'm on a marathon play session, but this game is so fun. So I'm gonna go ahead and I can make a better course than the ghost is able to. But don't tell him I said that! So, are you ready to try out the course? No. Yes, I am ready to try out the course. So I'm calling it Howl Hills. So based on the design of this whole area, I'm presuming that it's going to be pretty difficult to get my ball to land in certain places, but since the water doesn't seem to affect my strokes, I guess I could just plop it in the water any time I please. Blood Gators abound, there's stern warning. So he's got two names for the same hole. That looks like a very, very awkward landing. House is in my way. I guess I can do, like, fire it over there. Okay, I actually do have a shot here. Oh, maybe not, maybe not. I'll aim off to the... Oh, maybe not. Does it say I'll aim off to the side? I just want to do something safe-ish, at the very least. That, I'm guessing, isn't me safe-ish because it's curving around the house, but away from the trees. Yeah, that's okay, I guess. As a matter of fact, I could potentially just putt that in there. Maybe. Sure, I'll give it a shot. Woo! Yeah! You might have to shape this one a bit. That means the curve of the ball. In like a draw or a fade. I don't know, it doesn't look like I have to. Maybe I will. Oh, no. Just trying to find the sweet spot between the trees here or something, but I might just have to plunk it in the bunker. Or maybe I could try hitting it off of the cart path and going in the water on purpose, since it doesn't ruin my shots taken anyway. Oh, and I forgot to mention, the woods also had, like, antique... I should say the older woods, they didn't have numbers, they had various names of their own. We have Play Club, Brassy, Spoon, Baffy, Mashy, Spade, Niblick, Jigger, Rudder, I don't even know if that one's a real club in all honesty. And of course the putter. I really could just putt this one, based on... That. Yep. Okay. Good luck finding a fairway here! I guess it doesn't matter if I plunk it in the water, as I said. Oh, I was gonna say I could use my skimming woods. Well, no, I can't do that here. I forgot. I put all vintage clubs just to practice with them. So it's everything I hit is just gonna plop in the water. I guess it doesn't much matter if I hit in the water, because I'll just hit over the water and then on the green on the next shot. Or if I... I got an idea. Land it on this patch of land and bounce it to the other side. How you like? Oh, that might be too hard. It's going in the water. Well, whatever. That's the difference between a skimming wood and a regular wood. Actually, looks like I'll probably be able to make that in. Come on, rudder. We can do this. We can do this! Yeah! There are many ways to play this hole. My preferred method is driver. Probably the skimming driver. Well, actually I have... Well, he said the driver, but the driver would take me all the way there. Yeah, I don't really know if... I want to max it out, actually. Then go under... Wait, could I just, like, slam dunk it? That'd be so crazy if I could pull that off. It's like one shot, one kill, one down, make some grain at the mill or something. I don't know. I tried. Oh, it actually does add a shot. Do you see that? You see it go from 6 to 7 on the shots? Well, oh well. We'll see if it actually makes a difference. It's uphill. So... Really? That hole is huge! Okay, I just didn't hit it hard enough. I call this one a grave concern. Ooh, Can I bounce it off the ghost? Probably not, but that would be pretty fun. I guess I should probably hit over there so I have a more straight shot at it. Maybe, although this might yield me a little bit more room, perhaps. Although I think there's trees off to that side, if I recall correctly. Oh! I'm not sure if that... maybe I can do it. This might still be doable. I don't know what this landing area is yet. I forgot to drop a ball there to test it. It very well could be like quicksand or something for all I know. Let's test it out! Oh, it's just a bunker. Okay. That's not a big deal. Nice low running shot. That should do it. Or not. Okay. I guess my low running shot, despite how it looked on that on the little angular area there. Shot preview, I guess you could call it, didn't really go along that line. Wow, this one's a big one. This is probably the last hole then. So wait, was it the purple that was the deep rough or the bluish grass that was the deep rough? I think it was the blue. So I should probably hit to the purple. Woo! And it's gonna... of course. Well, there's still hope. There's... well, maybe not. I don't know. We'll see. Let's see here. Wait, no, I wanna... probably should go to the brassy. And... I'm gonna hope I get my shot in... or the next shot in on the... oh, shoot. I was gonna say, hope I get my next shot in on the fly, but... that's not looking like it's gonna happen. Well, oh, wait. No, maybe it doesn't affect my... shot total. I don't know. Because I thought I would've had... only one shot left after that, and I thought that would have been used up by the water, but I don't know. I gotta pay more attention. All right, spade. Let's do it. Okay, so I gotta be a little bit more course managey in some cases. I didn't design this one to be easy. No, you did not. Alright, like I said in the last part, this could be a whole part in on itself. So, we shall see. Maybe I'll get it on the second try. Who knows? I did it full power, but I went up and over, and then I did a curve. Something like that. You know what? It wouldn't actually hurt me if I went through the trees, would it? Because it would just roll forward onto the green anyway, wouldn't it? I would think, unless the tree is just gonna bounce me backwards. Oh! Should have tried that the first time. That certainly helps. Okay. Should I just aim for the water and just count the strokes? I don't know. I guess I'll try it. It's just gonna put me back on the green anyway, because of the whole it puts you at the last place you crossed over thing. See, that was shot just two. See that one? Yeah. That wasn't really... that didn't cost me a stroke at all. Okay. I'll take it then. I'll just overhit this. And she goes in. Good luck finding a fairway here. Even though that doesn't really matter that you don't have fairway, because it's just... you can put your ball in the water if you'd like to. Okay, let's try to bounce it off the land this time. Yeah, I probably should have switched again over to the skimming woods, but... I don't know, I still feel like I should get the hang of the antique clubs before I get into the later stuff, and although this is a pretty challenging little ordeal in on itself, so maybe I should be taking this little ordeal a little bit more seriously. Aww, thought I could have chipped it in. Just a smidge off. But a smidge is still one stroke. There are many ways to play, but the driver is his way. I'm gonna try that slam dunk thing that I was gonna try before. I don't know if it'll work, but why not? This time I'm gonna go full power Baffy, and hopefully it'll land right at the cup edge. Okay, so on the putt back this time, I'm gonna hit it at full power so I don't come up short, because that's what messed with me last time, and it costed me a stroke. Yeah, baby! I call this one a grave concern. I still would like to know if I can hit that ghost. I kind of wonder, what if I hit into a hole that I'm not supposed to hit into? This is probably a bad idea, but you'll probably just get a drop out of it or something like that. Oh, well, maybe we'll find out later. In some other challenge. Huh? Okay, so... No, I want to go long, if anything, because of that 7-yard range, and I don't want to end up back behind the water if I can help it. But I want to be over the water no matter what. Yeah, that was I got more power out of that than I wanted, but that's okay. It's still gonna be a 3-shot hole regardless of my little experiment of trying to hit in the other hole. It should go in, based on that trajectory and everything, with the wind, the slope, yeah. This one works better from this tee. And this is the big one. The one that did me in-ish. I'm gonna try playing this differently this time, because I noticed that other route was a little bit tight on everything. So I think if I go around, like, just the whole perimeter clockwise, I should have a better shot at this, in theory. Could be wrong about that, though. I'm gonna let my ball roll across the bridge, because why not? The bridge is technically a part of the course. So, oh, okay, it did not touch the bridge at all, but, well, I tried my best. Well, okay, it's touching the bridge now, I'll give it that. I presume I'm gonna have a decent amount of rollout because I'm using the vintage clubs, which have less spin, probably. Oh! You know, I hope this is the last hole. I'm assuming it is. I could be gravely wrong about this. Oh no, it wasn't the last! Holy poop! Call this one coming home. I hope this is gonna be a 2-shotter. Because I'm not sure how I'll be able to pull it off then. Yeah, I'm not sure how I would do this, in all honesty, because you'd have to be really spot on a lot of your shots to beat this. I guess I could bounce it off the bridge, at least try to bounce it off the bridge, get a little extra distance. Yes! No! Oh, I thought that was gonna be like against a fence or something like that. I didn't design this on anything. So, yeah. Wow. Okay, so if I'm gonna have to... I'm actually gonna have to take this seriously, aren't I? So we're gonna go with... certain stuff here. I don't know if the puddle wedge is a... whirly putter. Alright. Wow. Yes, I am. Alright, this is definitely the hardest challenge yet, for sure. And I hope that hole that I played was also the last hole, because that could be another issue as well. But we'll cross that bridge if we can hit it when we get there. yeah, I want to land it. I'll land it, like, somewhere back there, I guess. I suppose. Ooh, well, Mom, that might still work. Let's see. Just land short, and... oh yeah, I got it again! Okay. So... we're gonna try... I guess we're gonna try to go for more ones, as crazy as that sounds. Because obviously we need to be a little bit more efficient than we were. Well, I was. Okay, well, I could probably chip this in here with my shovel. Not a vintage name, this is a high-tech modern wedge. Slam dunked it. And... okay, now this one is the one that I was going to use to skip across the water. Only I kind of don't have to. Wait, actually, no. If I do skip it across the water, that would slow it down enough to land on the green, wouldn't it? We shall see! It seems like a good idea to try that. Well, sorta. I think I had the right idea, but I didn't play enough water. wait, hold on a sec. go with a lower running shot. No. Every time I try that, I mess up the timing on the... because it's so quick. Yeah, I just wanna try and guarantee my next shot goes in. Or, well, maybe I should have tried putting that, but that just seemed like such a long distance to even putt that. Well, I took a 3, again. But there is other ways to save strokes, I suppose. Like, say, actually making it in the hole this time. well, I mean, 2 shots on this one isn't that bad, but I'm still trying to get as efficient as possible. And again, if I go in the water, I guess it doesn't matter, so I'm just aiming for the absolute slam dunk here, otherwise it will not stop. Oh! That was awesome. Alright, so I guess that's a way to save shots there. That's right, I don't have a power shot when you're in these sorts of mini-games, so I can't give myself a little boost, but I might still be able to skim it across the water if I hit it, like, across that edge there. We'll see. Oh, I was a little bit off on the impact zone, but might still be okay. Oh, I didn't know it could skip when after it lands. Okay, that's alright. Just hit over this gravestone, and hopefully slam dunk this as well, because I don't have very much to go by here. Yeah. Oh no! I'm burning shots again. It's like that could have been a 2-hole. Yeah. Oh, that almost missed somehow. Okay, we're gonna go a little bit to the left of the hole. It's touchy. Trying to be super precise. Trying to be Michael Jordan. Shaquille O'Neal. Go! There's still possibilities around every corner. Oh, seriously? Oh. Off to the side. Swing true. Swing with love. And slam dunk. Why did that go? Oh, I guess the 7-yard range, but still. That still seems like such a large difference with such a short shot. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna make it this time. So I think I'm gonna do a quick restart over here. Yeah. Just do a couple little tappy taps really quick, because I was at 12 strokes there, and it takes me 3 to get there. And then I have 1 shot for the next hole, which is like a 3-shotter in on itself, so yeah. The slam dunk, while it is helpful, it shouldn't be a necessary thing in theory. It should just be something that just happens, like that. And see if that has an effect on its rollout, or I should say water bounce out. Oh my RCS, it hit the front bank! Oh, and it dropped me over there? Oh, that's terrible. It says I'm in the rough, but they put me in the water? Well, I will trust that it is the rough. And hopefully I can slam dunk this. Maybe. Yeah, it certainly played like it was in the rough. Oh, that's okay. And then a skipping shot across the water and across the green to the hole. A 2 would be a... Great. Of course you would hit the cauldron. Well, I might still have a shot. Yeah, I still do. Just gotta get off on that angle and use the skim to my advantage. Yes! Looking good! Okay. Because we have 3 shots to finish the last hole then, if that is the last hole. Well, actually, I shouldn't say that, because I still could very well miss this putt. As unlikely as it will be, because the size of the hole... Oh my god! Go ball! Into your home! I really hope this is the last hole, too. No. Yeah. Whew. Anywhere that I can cut off strokes, I am looking for. Oh, shoot. That might... Like, this run isn't looking good either. Yeah, maybe I'll just do a little of these really quick here, just to kind of... Yeah. Restart. I didn't mean to do that. Alright. We are set up to go again. Whew. We know it's possible. We just need to play better. We just need to believe in ourselves and the heart of the golf club. And that seems okay. Might go in the hole. At the very least, it'll be close. Oh, yeah! That's a good start. So about that shaping. I want to go around that way, I guess. Well, actually, you know what? I could try for the slam dunk, because it doesn't matter if it goes in the water, as I said before, because it doesn't really affect the strokes. So let's just slam it over there, and went over. Okay. So it'll be a two-shot hole then, unless I somehow miss this putt, which I would doubt. No. Hello. You never know. I thought I wasn't going to miss that putt over at that other one. Oh, but I did. But I did. You know what? Maybe I shouldn't try skipping it across the water here. Maybe that is my undoing. Or at the very least, maybe I should try with the backspin on that. Because maybe that'll stop it from going all willy-nilly, super hyper far after it skips across the water. Yeah, that's good. Okay. I'm having some happy thoughts with this run. This could be the one. Many ways to play it. But honestly, I'm going for the slam dunk as usual. Because if it goes in the water, it doesn't much matter. So might as well. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Yeah! Oh, wait. Oh, no. I said if it went in the water, it didn't much matter, but whatever it hit, it like hit the edge of the hole, and then it went all the way through, and well, now we might have lost our run. We'll see, I guess, because the deep rough, it might work with me, it might work against me. Okay, it's saved-ish. Okay, so top spin on this one, I found seems to be an okay way to play it. Land it in the rough to cut back on the rollout power and call it a hole, hopefully. Aww, I tried. Yeah, it's kind of tricky to get it to skip the way that you, exactly how you want to from the water, I've noticed, but well, it'll be okay. There's still hope. We can get a 3 on this one, and I think we'll still have enough strokes remaining to tackle the left one. Oh! Because I was going to say, after that one, I have to go for a 3 on this one, and then a 3 on the next one if I took a 10 again. You know, I mean 10 after that point. But it looks like we are one shot ahead here. That could change everything. I really want to just land in regular rough, if at all possible. I mean, I really want to be sure that I land in rough this time. So I'm going to try aiming over there and double skip it across the water. Or maybe single skip it, I'm not sure how it'll actually end up. Okay, there we go. I don't have a full idea of the skimming woods' true potential just yet. Oh, wow, I can actually go straight for it. I don't have to skip it across the water at all. Okay. This is looking very promising. Alright. That should stop on the green near the hole, or maybe even go in. Oh! So I guess that's what it hit on that other hole when it bounced way over. Because it, the hole, maybe it is like a funnel shape or something like that. And it just hit like the front edge of the funnel and just rocketed forward. Alright, 4 shots for the win. I think I've got it this time. If I don't have it this time, I would be very surprised. Because this has been a very, very efficient round compared to the rest of them. Okay, here we go. So we're going to try and get this down in 2 more shots, if at all possible. I don't know about that deep rough's range, but we'll see. Yeah, that gave me a little bit of a flyer. A flyer is when the ball goes further. Oh, that's dirt. That's not a cart path. Interesting. Yeah, a flyer is when your ball goes further out of the rough than you were expecting. Wait, hold on. This is regular rough. I can putt through this, can't I? Okay. I'm playing it smart here, because I have two shots. So I'm going to go hit there. Yeah! Woo! I don't know how you held your nose there so well in a place like this. Think I'll head to Tidy Park next. The place could benefit from my modern sensibilities. Alright, so it's sounding like that I was supposed to go here all along instead of Tidy Park. Well, oh wait, no, I couldn't have because I didn't have the key to the gate. So yeah, I was supposed to go to Tidy Park and come back here, and then we're going to go back over to Tidy Park. Oh, that was pretty difficult. Difficulty is finally ramping up in the game for sure. I thoroughly enjoyed that challenge. Now, where is that other buoy that I seen around the waterline? It was floating around here somewhere. I'm probably better off instead of running and just like dropping a ball and then moving my cursor around. Oh, there's one of those rainbow holes. Yes, a rainbow. We must hit in the rainbow, just for the sake of getting everything. I should always look for a rainbow, because there's probably going to be one in some new area. Looks good. Nailed it! Woo! Alright. Level up! I will boost my drive, I guess, a little bit. Keep my spin to hopefully stop my ball. I don't know. Or maybe that's just the curve of your ball, I don't know. I really like the accuracy though, because that seems to keep my ball online on my miss hits, so that's why I've been kind of boosting it. At least I think that's what's happening. Yeah, where'd the other buoy go? at least. Oh, wait. There it is. Okay. Yeah. Okay, make sure it's touching it, so we know we're at the right angle. Play the wind and let her fly! Okay. I don't know if I missed another buoy, because remember I said that there was that other buoy that I didn't re-find after I thought I found? But, well. I guess maybe some buoys are better left unfound. I don't know, actually, I think maybe I did find it. It just maybe I thought I didn't find it, but yeah. And also, I'm wondering about that bone structure in the water there, because remember, we're able to dig at certain spots that are like that. And, we kind of can't traverse the water, so it's kind of making me wonder if I'll get, like, scuba gear sometime in the future or something. Or not! Oh, what'd I do? Oh! I started something. Okay, looking. You just hit a ball in there and you find the digging spot. Okay. Were there other things like that? Is it? Woo! My spectators are not gonna get this chunk of money. Now, wasn't there another series of bones somewhere around here too? I don't know. I'd have to like drop a ball and skim around. I'll just go toot 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 like a radar or something. I'm gonna end up cutting a lot of this part anyway, based on all the failed runs that I had. So. I'm assuming that I'm going to need more footage than what I've already cut out at this point. I think I got this place pretty well cleared out. Including the manor. The manor, I opened up every single box I possibly could. They have their minions, so they are happy. So I guess they aren't going to actually take over the world, and we're not going to face a big old zombie skeleton final boss that drives 400 yards or something like that. No, they sit here probably. Maybe, I don't know. Oh, wait, did I hit a ball? Yeah, that was the place that I hit the ball to from on the other side. So yeah, I guess I was the only one here then. But I really should take a look out, keep a lookout for those sorts of bone structures or whatever they are in other places, because maybe, just maybe, they will have other stuff to hit to, because they always seem to be like a marker of some kind. Anyway, Tidy Park. Which I will, well, maybe find the caddy at in the next part? I still don't know who I'm looking for as a caddy, so... So anyway, I hope you enjoy, and I will see you in the next part when I maybe find the caddy, maybe do some side quests that I didn't think of at the time. I don't know, but I am actually going to stop recording for the day, because I've talked a lot today and I could feel I'm getting a little bit on the raspy side. So I hope you enjoyed, and toodaloo!